Okay, I'm out here. We'll make this pasture care too. This little horse right here is, of course, it's a mare and a gelding. See him dropping behind her. He was just doing the Fleeman response, where he lifts that nose up and gets it nice and high. And what that does is open up the senses so he can grab all the smells in the air. And you'll see a mare do that every once in a while with a baby, but I kind of couldn't get the camera on quick enough to discuss a little herd behavior. Now, this is a different pasture, and you can tell the grass out here is a lot longer. The other pasture that I did, if you watch Pasture Horse Care 1, most of the grass was like this, all eaten down, very short, very thin. Now we have some good longer grass, and if you look across here, you've got a lot of stuff to eat out here. So I originally pulled my horses off this pasture because they were getting a little too chubby. Somebody wrote me and asked if having a hay belly is bad. Well, bad is relative. You know, a hay belly, your horse is probably eating a little too much and he may be a little overweight, and it may cause him, you know, just like people. If we get overweight, sometimes our feet or knees hurt. Well, horses do the same thing. So you don't want to have them too overweight, but a little hay belly ain't going to kill nobody. And you know what? I got a hay belly myself, so I understand that they like to eat, and I like to eat, and, you know, if I'm riding them more and working them more, they'll lose that. So, the thing about a hay belly is not good is sometimes people confuse a hay belly with a worm belly. And if a horse has worms or is very wormy, their belly gets almost swollen, and it looks like a hay belly, when in fact, they're wormy. So, if a horse is thin and very small, and there's a link, I'll attach it on the description. I need to add it to my website. But it gives a link to a nice page that explains the weight and how to tell when a horse is underweight, overweight, fat, obese, etc. And I'll connect that link once I add it to my site to the description on this video. So if you go to the description of this video and click on the link, it'll explain to you how you can tell if a horse is underweight, overweight, obese, etc. And it has to do with looking at the flanks and the spinal down the middle. Is there a ridge there? Their belly, can you see the ribs? Can you feel the ribs? There's all kind of things on overweight. But a hay belly is not going to kill them. But, you know, a wormy belly, it can kill them. It'll cause them a colic. If they've got what looks like a hay belly and they're thin everywhere else and they have all these other cues or signals that they're underfed, and they have a hay belly, then it's not a hay belly. It's a worm belly, and you need to worm your horse to get rid of some of those worms. Now, Buddy and this little guy started playing again. Now, Buddy just got his butt kicked, and he didn't actually get his butt kicked. He's higher than this horse. Buddy's about 6 or 7, and this little horse right here is 2, maybe 3. And he's been hanging out here with these mares that don't want to play and with this older gelding that don't want to play, because this older gelding has these 2 mares, and he's dropping, and he thinks he's king stud, so he don't have time to play. So this little guy's been wanting to play, and Buddy loves to play. So now that they hooked up, they've been playing, and Buddy's showing dominance here. See the heads? See the low? He's trying to teach him that I'm going to get your neck, how to keep your neck away from me, how to keep your knees away so I can't bite your knees and drop you to the ground, because if I get your knees, I'll drop you to the ground. And this head bobbing and stuff, if you play with your horse too much and he starts treating you like a horse, he'll do that to you. And his head will knock you out because it's like a stinking anvil. But horses, they bang each other's head and they'll kick. And now this little horse, the one on the right, Buddy's the blonde on the left. The one on the right, the little sorrow, chestnut, whatever you want to call him with the braided tail. He's young and he's playing. Look, he's stomping the ground. He's trying to be big. He's trying to say, I'm stronger than you. And Buddy's like, yeah, whatever. So Buddy found another guy that he can dominate. So they're playing. So now they go, see Buddy went straight for these. So does Butt. He's going to kick. Buddy throws his head. Buddy's going to say, I'll move you. Tanner taught it. Tanner taught you that shit, didn't he, Buddy? Big T, you taught him well. A smart horse knows how to spin that butt because that's the power. That front end and biting and rearing crap may impress the ladies and it looks big, and they learn how to strike and they learn how to bite, and 2 stallions will fight that way. But a good seasoned horse knows that's how you get injured. That's how you get hurt. That's how you get a broken front leg. If you want to fight with a horse and a horse is smart, he's going to turn and give you both barrels. And that's where his power's at. And a horse, see that little horse? He wants to back into Buddy. Buddy's going to bite him in the butt. So, Buddy is pushing, and when I first let these horses out here, you saw an immediate pairing up. You saw an immediate pecking order. This horse over here kept his two hot mares and says, hey, these are my women. They're both breeding age, and they're mine. And they don't really want the little runt, the little two-year-old, hanging around them, because the little two-year-old wants to play, and he's a male, and out in the wild, he would be kicked off and be in a bachelor herd. And they would not let him stay. But because he's in pasture, he gets to hang around his mom. The little sorrel over here, in between the middle horse there, is his mom. So he's been hanging out with his mom. He feels comfortable with her. I think they're going to end up breeding her here soon if she's not already bred. She's pretty big. Her belly, she's got a big hay belly. If I can remember, I'll go over there and film that. But the one on the left is the gelding, and then these two are mares. So he's kind of staying in between the rest of the herd. Now, Tanner went out here and hooked up with these other two geldings out here because they're older. Both those white horses, or the grays, are older. Now, Buddy's going to go over and try to make friends with this guy, but this guy's like, look, you little youngster, don't come play with me. Got his tail and walked off. He got that tail swish and said, I don't want to play. Because he's older. He's probably got arthritis. He's 30 years old. He's got a sunken back. He's sore. Last thing he wants to do is be goofing around out here and hurt himself. Kind of like a bunch of old people that get into horses and they don't want to get hurt. So all they want to do is kind of like feed the horse and have a horse, but they're afraid to get on or do anything because they don't want to get hurt. Well, that's how these old horses are. They don't want to be playing. They don't want to get mixed up in a herd. Now, you see Tanner kind of pushing them. Tanner's the brown horse. And he's moving those two white ones, and he's separating them. And Buddy's trying to get in over there. But Tanner came out here, and I'm surprised he didn't challenge that other gelding and take those mares. Now, if I leave these horses out here for a day or two, Tanner's going to have those two mares probably in the morning. Slowly but surely, he's going to weasel his way over there closer, closer. He'll be flirting with those mares. And then all of a sudden, him and that gelding's going to have a challenge. And Tanner's going to put that big four-barrel butt of his into action. And he's going to take those two mares. But these two right here are two geldings. Buddy and Leo are both young geldings. So they're more into playing. They're not so much worried about women. Why? Because Tanner is high horse, and Buddy knows he ain't going to take no women from him. And now this horse. Now this horse is coming on over here. And he left his two mares. Which kind of surprises me that the mares aren't sticking to him. They usually want to hang a little bit closer. Now, this guy's not really old, so he's still young enough to play. And him and Buddy used to play when they were both younger a few years ago. But, you know, this little guy, he just wants to play. And Buddy just wants to play. Buddy's never kind of, you know, been out to where he had to fight and defend and get his own mares and have his own herd. But he's getting to that age now. That's why he's not hanging with Tanner. Normally, Buddy would be hanging with Tanner because that's where he gets his strength and that's where he feels comfortable. This horse is going to come up. Now, I don't know if he's going to push this little guy. He didn't. He's going to walk up to Buddy. Now, Buddy sees him. He may act like he don't see him. He sees him. Look at that tail. Look at that tail. Now he changes direction. That little tail switch there told him, don't walk up on my butt like that. So now they walked up. Buddy, look at Buddy. I'm not real sure if he pushed Buddy or if Buddy ignored him. And that's why watching these horses, when you watch them all the time, is you're always constantly trying to figure out what just happened there if you're looking deeper into how these horses communicate. Did Buddy be aloof and say, hey, I don't need to even pay you respect. I'll just kind of walk away and ignore you? Or did this horse push Buddy and say, I want this little guy back, move away? Now, one of those two things happened, and I'm not real sure which it did. My guess would be this guy said, I want him back, and Buddy said, I'm going to go to Big T where I feel comfort. That would be my guess. But it could have been Buddy went, you know what? You can have him. I don't care. He's not in my herd. I got Mr. T. I'm going to walk on over here. Screw you. And he could have left him. But again, understanding... here comes Tanner. Tanner, oh, look at that position. Look at Tanner walking. That's a challenge. Okay, here we go. These Tanner's going to come out here and go, hey, dude, don't come walking up like your king horse. So these two guys right here are going to, look at that. They're going to meet at the nose. One of them may stomp. One of them may show, oh, here comes the mares. Oh, they know something's going on. They go, uh-oh, let's go see what's going on. So they're coming in. Look at Tanner. Show my butt. You want some of this? Big T went, don't go by Buddy. Now see, Big T got in front and he stopped that other horse. Big T's in the front, the other horse, he stopped his position because he cut him off. He's showing dominance by saying, I can stop your feet. I can control where you go. Look at Big T, stopped. Don't walk up on me. Gave that little tail, put his head up like, don't make me kick you. Every time they do something like that, they're creating dominance. They're showing who's going to run who. Now, these guys stopped when they got the little horse because Mr. T and that other horse kind of walked off. But there's a lot of talking going on here. There's a lot of fronting off. See that horse? He keeps pushing Mr. T. He's not backing away. He's smelling. There goes Mr. T's tail. He's still smelling him, and he's kind of encroaching on Mr. T. Now, he got between Buddy and Mr. T. Look at Tanner. Mr. T turned around, said, hey. They're sniffing nose. They're exposing their flanks, saying that we're not mortal enemies. We're not fighting right now, but neither one's backing down. Neither one's showing strong dominance. Neither one's being aggressive, but neither one's backing down. And understanding that when you're working with your horse to where you don't necessarily have to show them who's boss all the time. You can show a horse that you're not weak by just holding your ground, making sure they understand they can't get away. They can't push you. They can't move your feet. See, a horse will start moving your feet nonchalantly. You won't know what's happening. Next thing you know, that horse will say, you know what? I can move your feet and you didn't listen. I'm going to kick you to make sure you know that I'm higher. But because people don't understand what happens, next thing you know, their horse is kicking them. And they're like, I had this horse and he was really good and there was nothing wrong. And now 6 months later, he's kicking me. Rick, can you help me stop him? No, I can't help you stop him because you taught him to stink and kick you for 6 months. That's all you did. So if you don't understand that you taught him to do that, how can I teach you not to do it? You need to understand how horses react, how they intermingle. These two, Tanner and this other gelding right now, is really working out some pecking order right now. And other people would look out here and go, oh, isn't that sweet? All these horses are just getting along grazing. No, that ain't what happened. These two horses over here are seeing which one's going to be higher. These two horses in the middle are figuring out who's going to be higher. Buddy's kind of watching. He's paying attention to watch how Mr. T takes over. Mom went back with a little baby, and this mom's over here. Look at this mom. This mom's like, hey, where's the two geldings going? What's going on? Because the two geldings are the two high horses are walking off. So right now, if you look out here on who's high horse, you wouldn't be able to know. I know these horses, so I pretty much know Tanner's high horse. Now look at Tanner. Walk right by his butt saying, look, I'm going to expose my flank. You can kick me, but you don't want to. Tanner's got his tail. Now look at Tanner making him follow him. See, people think that Tanner just turned around and walked away. He made that other horse follow him. He's establishing dominance without this other horse. This other horse knows what's happened. Most people don't know. Look at him shaking his tail. Follow me. I'm making you move my feet. I'm showing you I'm dominant. Stand behind me. Don't pass me. Don't control my feet. Don't cut me off. Look at Tanner. You're not paying attention to me. I'm going to cut off in front of you again. Now this horse is like nibbling a little bit. Hey. Let's be friends. Oh, Tanner just told him, hey, I'm not ready to be friends. I'll let you know when we can be. See that tail? That one's getting down there to smell. Tanner's going to correct him in a minute. I wish I had a good zoom where I could really zoom in on these horses, but with this camera, if you click full screen on these, it improves the video, and you can also pick, I guess, 480 or something. There's a higher video quality, and it makes it to where you can see this a little bit better. And the sun's so bright out here, I'm just kind of guessing that I'm in the center of the screen. I can't really tell. I'm at 13 minutes here, so I only got a couple minutes left. I wish they would kind of get a little bit more, figure out who's dominant here. But they're grazing together. They're establishing relationships. They're community. See that horse? Tanner looked down and he walked down. They're showing that nose. Look at Tanner. Oh. See, I think Tanner pushed him, but I can't tell. They both could have went. See, that one's not backing down, though. See how he's nuzzling Tanner? He's slowly trying to say, hey, come on, let's be. He may bite him and say, hey, is this okay? But neither one's being mean, yet they're establishing dominance. And that's what people, that's when you get all these freaking yahoos out here that want to tell you, show a horse who's boss, get on that bit, whip them, use that rope, hit that. That's all BS. They don't know any better. This is how two high horses work out their dominance. They walk, they communicate, they move each other's feet, they stop the other one from moving their feet. They simply show that I can control you and that you can't control me. But the only way that other people know how to work a stinking horse, they run out there and they want to push and make him run and chase him around a stinking round pen and thinking that's the only way you can show dominance. Tanner is showing dominance. Tanner's on the right now. The other horse, the other gelding's on the left. He is showing submissiveness. He's following Tanner. He's listening to what he says. He's letting him stop his movement. He's letting him walk where he wants to. If you're not paying attention, you can't tell who's control. Okay, here comes Buddy. Oh, shit, I'm at 14 and a half. See, if Buddy goes over there, that's going to change the dynamics a little bit because Tanner is going to want to get protective or want to take Buddy and say, don't get in the middle. Or Tanner's going to get pissed at Buddy for saying, don't distract me. I'm in the middle of establishing some dominance and I got to pay attention. See how horse wants to get down by his gelding? All right, I'm going to do, I'll do another video on this because this may get good. Hopefully it will. So we're going to stop here at 15 minutes.